your docking clearance to an Alliance official.
Figures. Finally back in action, the Alliance already wants us tagged and collared.
Just our way of welcoming you back, Flight Lieutenant.
Yes, ma'am. Requesting docking permission?
Docking permission granted. Would you like private transport arranged?
I need to get to the hospital.
Yes, Commander.
Gel is low, but
I found this metagel formula. Figured you could make good use of it.
Where did you find this? Never mind, it doesn't matter. Yes, we can put this to good use. Thank you. Tasteless to call this place Huerta Memorial.
What's going on here?
Ma'am, I'll cut you a deal. You buy us 90 million credits worth of life-saving equipment, and you can name the hospital whatever you want.
Now the truth comes out. My job here is done.
Welcome to Serta.
Be safe.
Hello again, Commander. Here to see our patient?
How is Ashley doing?
Stable. There's no evidence of cognitive impairment from the concussion, but multiple shoulder fractures are still on the mend. Bed rest under observation is all that's needed now. I'm sure a visit would be welcomed.
Keep up the good work, Doctor.
You too, Commander.
Asari Intelligence is reporting sightings of Reaper forces in the Suian Nebula.
I'm trying to place a call to Grissom Academy. They have biotic amp interfaces?
I overheard you talking. Grissom Academy is gone, but I found this while I was there.
What is this? Yes, these are tailored to human physiology, but with a few alterations, they should work for the Asari as well. This is exactly what I needed. Thank you.
Listen to me, those prototypes are vital. We need these biotic upgrades to fight the Reapers.
You can replace my leg, right?
Yes. But clone tissue replacement takes months. You'll need a prosthetic. I highly recommend talking to our resident psychiatrist before the operation.
I'd like an answer, Lieutenant Commander. The galaxy has need of exceptional soldiers like you, now more than ever.
I still need time. You'll have my answer soon, I promise.
I look forward to it. Shepard?
Udina? I got your email. Made your decision yet?
On becoming a Spectre? Not yet. It's an honor and all. But I don't know. I need to think about it some more.
It's a big decision. Smart to give it some thought. Here, I picked this up for you. Figured you had some downtime.
Thanks. That's sweet. I've been climbing the walls.
How are you doing?
Good, considering. The nurse said you checked in on me earlier. Still out cold, I guess.
We didn't have time to talk. I thought maybe if you were up for it.
Yeah, I wasn't sure you wanted to. You were pretty clear on Mars about where things stood.
What do you mean?
You're not a part of Cerberus anymore. Case closed. Full stop.
It's the truth.
Okay. You cut all ties. I accept that. It's just that if you're giving the orders, I need to be able to count on you.
You can't rely on anyone. Sounds harsh, but it's true. Comes down to doing what you think is right, and damn everyone else.
I get that.
Good. As a Spectre, that's rule number one. When you're back on your feet, we'll talk some more.
Shepard, wait. There's one more thing. I wasn't sure if I should mention it.
What is it?
I have family back on Earth. I haven't heard from them. It's making me crazy. But I know you're busy, Shepard. We can talk later.
I've got time to talk. I should get back to it. Take care of yourself.
Will do, Commander.
Over here.
First deployment is somewhere near Palavan. Reports say not to depend on comms.
I'll leave vid messages then, and you can do the same.
Well, they said that due to concerns about signal congestion, we're supposed to avoid sending messages at all. They're trying to keep war data coming through, so every data packet counts.
So how am I supposed to talk with you then?
Commander Shepard, it's been far too long. We live in interesting times.
A little too interesting.
I couldn't get anywhere near you when the Alliance had you locked up.
Relieved of duty. It was complicated.
I'm sure it was. I'm surprised they didn't court-martial you. The Alliance isn't known for its flexibility.
Doesn't matter now.
Shepard, about Earth.
Countless people lost their lives within minutes. The Reapers are everything we feared.
They should have listened to you a long time ago. I'm sorry, Shepard.
What about you? What brings you here?
I need to talk to a few people. Like you. The Citadel is a good place to meet. For now. What's the Alliance's next move?
We have a plan. It's a long shot.
Not surprising. Shepard, there's something I wanted to mention.
What is it?
I haven't heard from my sister, Oriana, for a while. I'm getting worried.
Your sister?
My father never stopped looking for her, even when I was working for Cerberus. I used every resource they had to hide her, and I knew he'd find her somehow. My father is obsessed. Dangerous. I don't want Oriana to suffer like I did.
What do you need from me?
I appreciate the offer, Shepard, but you have your hands full. If I need a door or two kicked down, I know just who to call. But for now, I'll be fine.
Okay. I understand.
I have to figure this out.
You will. I've got to get back to it.
And I should get out of sight.
Be careful.
No promises.
You finally made it off the Normandy.
Glad I did. Even with the chaos of all the refugees, seeing so many ships in flight is comforting. Gets me thinking. Hey, a Turian frigate. I think that's the PFS Havenkaw.
What's one Turian warship doing at the Citadel?
Looking for dry dock, I bet. She's seen battle. Look at the Waver and her drive core emissions. Alone, limping, looking for a haven. Maybe it would have been better to just go down fighting, like their families back home.
The lives of future generations rest on those Turian shoulders, on our shoulders. Nobody's given up. Not those Turians, not me, not you.
If anyone can pull this all together, it's you. And I'm with you. Gotta let go. For real this time. The refugees here have put up a memorial wall. They leave mementos of lost loved ones. I was thinking maybe...
What's stopping you?
Nothing. I mean, let me think about it.
Welcome, Commander Shepard. One moment, please. Now arriving at Docking Bay E-24, Emergency Civilian Housing.
You can't take this way.
Yes, we can. Tell your friends to move their ship out of the dock.
Sure you can't squeeze in a few more people, officer?
And who the heck are you? Oh, Commander Shepard. If that's what you think, I'll find them some room.
So my family can dock?
Commander Shepard says your family's cleared. Just tell them to hurry.
Thank you, Commander. Thank you so much.
Excuse me, what was your name again?
Dakar.
Christoph Wasser. Good to meet you. How long have you been here?
I don't know. I'm not in the...
I don't know how long it was since I escaped Lyon. Do you know Lyon?
No.
Let's check on those medigel supplies.
Yes, sir.
And have we heard anything from the hospital?
The surgeons there are all busy.
Keep on it. Some of these wounded don't have much time.
Shepard.
What's happening?
We convinced the council to accept our wounded. Nowhere else to go.
How bad is it?
More dead than injured. 85% killed in action. We'll need a morgue soon. Not a lot of flesh wounds when you're fighting Reapers.
Do what you can for them.
A few of them might get back on their feet, but the rest... Sympathy is about all we can offer.
Any sign of your family?
Not yet, but I keep hoping. What about you? I'm starting to see some wear and tear.
I won't lie. It's been rough.
Well... Don't forget to come up for air. There's a lot more war to go.
You are looking at VI model 1.7 AGB, Commander Shepard. Please see a store clerk to unlock a demo of this model.
You have a copy of a Shepard VI?
Oh, yeah. The one based on that war hero? We locked it after some kid spilled soda over the hardware. I'll unlock it, but we've only got the demo version working.
Covered your pillars of strength from the cut.
Welcome to Batarian State Arms.
Thank you. Right now, my people.
Batarian State Arms, defending the hegemony.
Commander Shepard, please select a destination.
One moment, please.
Now arriving at Presidium Commons.
So, you want us to enlist as soldiers? Isn't there anything else we can do?
You two could save lives by helping doctors in the refugee camps.
Thanks? Who was that?
Welcome to Kanala Exports.
Yeah, that's good advice. Let's sign up as med tent volunteers.
Cultivating serenity is possible even during times of crisis. We appreciate your visit.
Overcharging for goods, denying refugees.
Welcome to Elkos Combine Arsenal Supplies. Any opened goods can only be returned for store credit.
Forgiveness of debts in times of war. Of course, the book
Elkos Combine. Come again. If it exists, we carry it.
Selling now would be unwise. I'm aware of what's happening. Offload them into the Motan cluster. And then I'd advise traveling someplace safer. I wouldn't go to the settled worlds. Larger colonies appear to be priority targets.
I think I'm ready to end it with him. Things weren't great even before we arrived, and I would die.
If we switch from financial VIs to military gear, we'll lose millions.
Who cares about the money? Haven't you heard the news from Palavin?
That's what your army is for.
I've seen Palavin burning. Those fires aren't going out anytime soon. If you can help.
Look, Cyrus, you want to sell your shares and walk fine. But I'm not selling financial VIs.
The Council called the invaders.
Right. We'd be able to use most of the hard enemy. The financial VI has more processing power.
Thinking of going? To Sanctuary. I don't think I can do this anymore.
We must find a way to stabilize the heating unit so the water temperature can remain steady. The colony's location is hardly ideal for our species.
Because of the apparel,
I'm afraid I can't help you.
Look, he is not gonna leave. The sooner you refund him, the sooner you go home.
Yeah, you're right. Let's get this over.
Welcome to Agor Munitions.
Here, I've sent you a full refund.
Really?
Yes.
Remember, all purchases made. Welcome to Supertine Armory.
Yes, congratulations. The whole 15 credits.
Thank you for shopping at
Supertine Armory.
Report as AM Trading Limited.
Welcome to the Citadel Gift Shop.
Welcome to Nos Astra Sporting Goods. Shoot smart. Shoot Nos Astra. Thank you for shopping at Nos Astra Sporting Goods. Welcome to Casa Fabrication Weaponry. Proceeds from all purchases go to help our men.
Hello, Shepard. You look like you're gathering data.
That is a safe assumption.
Anything big and world-shaking? Man's inhumanity to man. Does objective reality really exist? That kind of thing.
I was running scenarios in my head to analyze Jeff's behavior. I believe he has a strong affectionate attachment to me, but he has not stated it to anyone yet. When you are sexually interested in another, what kind of advances do you make?
You know, there are the intimate talks, thoughtful gifts, joking around.
Jeff does often try to lighten the mood with humor. That could indicate a 33.3 repeating percent chance that he cares for me. But that is insufficient data for determining his motives. Perhaps we could discuss how to provoke Jeff into an emotional commitment.
That's
not how to think of it. It's gotta be natural. You need chemistry.
I see. There are a number of pharmaceuticals I could inject to simulate the desired emotional state.
No, I mean relax and do something you both like. Something simple. For example, you both like humor.
Correct. I will see if there are comedic entertainment shows being presented on the Citadel. Scanning. Do you think he would like The Man Who Hung Himself? It appears to be about an amorous plastic surgeon.
Edie, the important thing is to have a good time, wherever you go. And if you're having fun, he probably will too.
Then the outcome is an unknown quantity, but you are saying I should attempt it anyway.
Nobody ever fell in love without being a little bit brave.
I see. I believe you have improved my chances, Shepard. Thank you.
Hey, Commander, check it out. Big news, the Blasto movie is breaking opening week records. There's also a big expose on Quasar tournaments, tips on how to make your apartment look bigger, and, oh yeah, a big-ass Reaper invasion. These people have no idea.
Sometimes I think this whole Citadel is a mistake.
What do you mean?
Well, it's out here in the middle of nowhere. Defensible, safe. You can be damn sure nobody on Earth or Palavin is watching vids or playing Quasar.
But up here, nobody has to get their hands dirty. Meanwhile, they ignore the unshackled AI walking around the Presidium.
She run into any trouble?
No, she's my mobility assistance mech. Thanks to Vrolik Syndrome, I'm legally entitled to bring her everywhere. Finally getting some use out of those disability benefits.
I'm sure she appreciates getting out to see the sights.
Ah, she's earned a little shore leave.
We've got to keep Jake in daycare. We should be socializing with other two.
But what if there's another attack?
We can't spend our lives waiting.
According to the Council, these galaxy-wide attacks are part of a massive and organized invasion.
Still working?
One call leads to another, and here I was hoping I'd have time to enjoy the view. The last time I saw the Presidium, remember how it was all rubble after Sovereign attacked?
I barely got to see the Presidium before half of it got crushed.
And by the time they repaired it, it was time for the next invasion. Citadel hasn't seen the reality of this war yet. We should stock up on necessities while we can.
Such as?
Izo, heavy arms, mercenary groups.
We'll get the people. Take a moment for yourself now and then.
I know. But there's always just one more task or meeting. Speaking of which, talk to the Volus, Barlavon. He'll point you to some mercenaries willing to join us.
Reapers, the same term once used by a disgraced
Combine Arsenal Supplies.
Please visit any of our LCOS Combine affiliate branches for any and all personal needs. Welcome, Commander Shepard. Please select a destination. One moment, please. Now arriving at Presidium Embassy.
But what I need is... I fully understand the situation. Of course I read through the names of the dead every day, but... Please! Please, a few more minutes of searching could mean a lifetime of peace for my family.
Someone in your family is MIA?
My son, Bilal. And bureaucratic compassion seems to be in short supply. I am Ambassador Dominic Osoba. My son's squad returned from their mission on Benning without him. I found them drinking, but they won't even look me in the eye. I can offer a bounty for any information. If Bilal's alive, we want him home. If he's dead, then we can begin to mourn him.
If I find anything, I'll let you know.
Thank you. Either way, you will set my mind at ease.
The Council called the invaders Reapers, the same term once used by a disgraced
Corps. I think I recovered the obelisk you mentioned from the Shrike Abyssal. It's waiting in Bay D-24.
Incoming Reaper forces. Fierce fighting continues as the Reapers occupy most of the town. It appears that Turian forces may have lost their plan.
Good morning. Oh, hello, ma'am.
Ma'am?
We'd have this discussion.
Commander Shepard, John Dumbau, Special Tactics and Recon. I've got intel suggesting that high-level Hanar officials may be indoctrinated.
That's a damning accusation. What have you got?
Evidence of an Alliance Black Ops team raiding a Batarian research station. The Batarians were studying Reaper technology.
The Batarians had Reaper technology?
The Alliance raid turned into a massacre, and the humans ended up with nothing. Your people faked a power failure to hide the incident.
The Batarians would have gone to war if they'd found out. But how does this implicate the Hanar?
They maintain discreet gray market trade relationships with the Batarians and led the Alliance to the station. We suspect those Hanar operatives escaped with Batarian tech. If your reports on the Reapers are accurate, they could already be indoctrinated.
What's your source on all this?
I paid off a weapons dealer, Donovan Hawk. Unpleasant man, but the data was worth it.
What do you need me to do?
The Hanar operative is now a diplomat on the Citadel. I don't have a public name, and the Hanar will go to ground if I make a formal inquiry.
So we're hunting?
I'm tracking suspicious transmissions to the Hanar homeworld. I could use your help.
Let me see what I can dig up at the Spectre office.
Thanks, Shepard. And for the record, not everyone doubted your concerns about the Reapers. I just hope we're not too late.
Shepard, I'm checking security reports. Can you track the transfers coming from the Hanar Embassy?
On it. Any idea what you're hoping to find?
Suspicious transfers. Data usage outside the normal range for ambassadorial staff.
So, we have no idea.
Hopefully we'll know it when we see it, Commander.
Beware that the council is not.
I have some possible hits. Got some strange money transfers on Balone. And Olun is sending a lot of data.
Balone's clean. His money transfers are to support his mistress. Not sure about Olun. I'll pull his bio.
I'll check Olun's personal records and pull his recent messages. And Balone has a mistress?
An Asari poet. To be honest, I think he was pressured into it to improve relations with Thessia.
His government approves of him having an affair with an Asari poet?
No, they'd fire him if it became public. They're a paradoxical culture.
Tell me about it.
Welcome, Commander Shepard. Please. One moment, please. Now arriving at Docking Bay E-24.
Bao. Olun's doing some heavy lobbying for the Hanar to support the war effort.
So he's clearly not indoctrinated. Who's opposing him?
An unnamed Hanar recently posted here from Kaje. I'll check transit records.
Good idea. There shouldn't be many new arrivals. They're a mildly xenophobic species.
Xenophobic?
I could use a more polite term if you prefer. Private? Reclusive?
Just a bit more blunt than I expected.
I did say mildly.
I've got a list of new Hanar arrivals, Bao. Forwarding it to...
Damn. These are all face names. The Hanar names from the Alliance raid are soul names. And Hanar soul names are private. There's no public record. Can you get back to their personal communications?
On it. Maybe we'll find names there.
We can hope. If a Hanar group is opposing war with the Reapers, my suspicions were correct.
Bao, here's the correspondence. If there's any mention of soul names...
I've got it. A recent arrival. Zemandis. Soul name regards the works of the Enkindlers in despair. He was with the Alliance team that massacred the Batarians. He's been on special research assignment ever since.
So, he got his tentacles on some Reaper tech.
Looks that way. I'm sending you the nav point for his office. I'll meet you there.
Welcome, Commander. One moment, please. Now arriving at Presidium Embassy.
Yes, his squad did return. I could, but they ignored me.
Zemandis?
Or should I say, regards the works of the Enkindlers in despair?
It seems this one has been apprehended, but confinement is irrelevant. The work of the Enkindlers cannot be stopped.
Why are you trying to help the Reapers?
This one follows the will of the Enkindlers.
The Protheans?
No. They were false prophets. I serve the true Enkindlers. Their voices speak in my mind.
It appears that indoctrination has severely affected his mental functions.
Your skepticism does not matter. When the Enkindlers uplift us as their chosen sapients, the galaxy will bear witness.
I don't think the Enkindlers are going to be doing anything today.
Your belief in your victory is mistaken. Our planetary defense network is largely automated. It can be disabled with a single virus, which I have just uploaded.
Damn it. Wait. A virus would be detected unless sent on low priority channels, which have a time lag. I may be able to block the upload.
You may be delayed.
Forget about me! Stop the upload! Did you stop it?
We did it. The Hanar are safe.
Thanks, Shepard. Honored to work with you.
Thank you. Commander Shepard.
One moment, please.
Now arriving at ward level, Purgatory.
Can't believe he did that. They were refugees. Damn it, it's not like they had much left to start with.
I know people are complaining. We're doing what we can.
No. I'm telling you, I saw the book in his eye.
Hey! You ready to get the party started?
Hey, Commander. Nice to see you down here in the dirt with us grunts.
You think I don't like getting dirty?
Well, now, come on. I didn't mean anything by it, Lola.
Uh-huh. What did you mean, then?
See those Marines over there? None of them officers. Just soldiers fighting the war.
Yeah?
They've been buying me drinks all night. You know why? Same reason they got all quiet and serious when you walked in.
Maybe I should expect it. There aren't a hell of a lot of people who've done what I have.
And now they get to meet you in the flesh. You should buy them around. It'll impress them.
I like the way you think, Lieutenant.
Compadres! Hey! The commander would like you to have a drink. On her. So here's to us.
Who's like us?
Damn few! And they're all dead. Sorry, Shep. Thought you'd know that one.
Thanks for the warning.
Thanks for the drink.
Damn it, Moran.
Commander Shepard, maybe I can help. The banner of the 1st Regiment is waiting for you at Bay D-24.
So you admit you and your thugs are here illegally?
Yes, and it only took CSEC 3 weeks to figure it out.
I don't care who you are. You're required to go through processing like all other refugees. Come with me.
I don't think so. Shirk, get me the Asari counselor.
Arya, to what do I owe the pleasure?
I'm being asked to submit to immigration processing.
I see. And now you've been processed. Is there anything else?
Nothing. Thank you.
Anytime.
I think we're done here. Enjoy the show, Shepard?
I was asked here.
Yes. How very obedient of you. I apologize for my surroundings. This place can't hold a candle to Omega.
Then why did you leave?
Cerberus stole Omega from me. The elusive man is now squarely at the top of my shit list. He will pay for every second I've spent in this bureaucratic hellhole.
If it were me, I'd want revenge.
Glad to see we think alike. I'll take Omega back, but I'll get to that. You're here because I have a proposition.
I'm listening.
The way I see it, if you don't defeat the Reapers, we're all dead. Won't matter where I'm sitting. It's in my interest to help you.
What are you offering, Arya?
On Omega, I kept the Blood Pack, Blue Suns, and Eclipse in check. Now they're running amok. Nobody wants that. Unite them under my rule, and you'll have a powerful and ruthless force for your war. I've laid the groundwork with all three groups. I just need you to close the deals.
If they'll fight Reapers, I'll take them.
Now that's a bottom line I can respect. Meet with Gnarl, my agent who's dealing with the Blood Pack. The Blue Sun's leader is incognito here on the Citadel. He'll be expecting you. And I already have a deal with Jonas Sedaris, the Eclipse leader. You just have to get your friend, Commander Bailey, to let her out of jail.
You obviously don't know Bailey very well.
Bailey respects you. Lean on him. I think a united force of professional mercs is worth it. Don't you? It's always a pleasure, Shepard. Let me know if you want to talk later.
Commander Shepard. One moment, please. Now arriving at Docking Bay E-24. Emergency civilian housing.
Wow. Arya wasn't kidding. The great Commander Shepard on a leash.
I'm here for my own reasons, Vosk.
Oh, sure you are. Anyway, tell her I'm impressed, but to do business, I still need my little problem taken care of.
Which is?
A Taurian general named Oraka has it out for the Blue Suns. He's raising a stink over our activity in this sector. I'll commit my gang to Arya as soon as Oraka's dead.
You won't have to worry about Oraka for long.
Love it. Commander Shepard taking out the Blue Sun's trash, huh? That Arya is sure something special. Oh, and, tell Arya I still expect her blue ass in bed with me.
What is it, Shepard?
You knew about this?
Can you be more specific?
Darnar Vosk expects me to kill General Oraka.
Who cares what Vosk wants? What he needs is for Oraka to stop disrupting his operations. I figured you'd talk to Oraka, see if you can get him to lay off. And if he won't listen to reason, call me, and I'll take care of it.
No need to candy-coat it, Arya.
Ah, Shepard. You think you know me so well.
I just don't see why you couldn't tell me the details yourself. Yeah, he mentioned that,
That I'm going to sleep with him? We all have our delusions.
Commander Shepard, please select a destination. One moment, please. Now arriving at Presidium Commons.
Commander Shepard, I don't believe I've ever had the pleasure. Barlavon, financial advisor. We have a mutual acquaintance in Admiral Anderson. I wasn't surprised he demanded to remain on the ferocious battle on your home world.
We need more people like Anderson if we're gonna win this.
Agreed. That's where I can help you. A sizable mercenary group is offering their services to anyone who can rescue them from Reaper-controlled territory. Evacuate them, and they'll join your army.
I appreciate the information.
Just don't wait too long to act on it. The Reapers are advancing all too quickly. Come see me once you've completed the extraction. I'll be in my office a while longer. The galactic market is in considerable flux.
In these troubled times, don't the investors you trust?
Have you decided how to tell them?
I don't know. A text message is so impersonal.
According to the Council, these galaxy-wide attacks are part of a massive and organized invasion plan.
Quick! Hands behind your back. They'll be here any minute.
What the hell are you talking about?
Crete, Blood Pack's leader. Arya brings him the Great Commander Shepherd. Crete pledges the gang to her. We're just luring him into the open so we can take him out.
Not the best start to our friendship, Gnarl.
He's coming. Put your hands behind your back and try to look like I beat you up or something.
This better be on the up and up.
Quiet!
Arya to Luke, even more powerful than Crete thought. Her instructions on boarding Citadel undetected were one thing. Now this... Commander Shepard, want you to know, your head will be hood ornament on my personal shuttle.
Keep your distance, Crete. So... do you agree to Arya's terms?
Most definitely. Arya can use Blood Pack as she sees fit.
Wasn't talking to you, Crete. Grill?
What? You have my word. Now open fire!
Not him! Grill's next in line to take over. Arya's deal is with him.
Yes! Yes. I'm Arya's mole, Shepard. You've scratched my back. Now I'll scratch yours.
Word of advice, don't double-cross Arya.
I may be ambitious, but I'm not crazy.
Uh-huh. Good work, Gnarl. Thanks for the gun.
Anytime, Shepard. Grill and I will let Arya know the light is green.
Commander Shepard.
Your General Araka?
Reinstated.
I hear you're taking on the Blue Suns.
I need to do my part for the Citadel, Commander. The Blue Suns are raiding CSEC weapons shipments. I'm putting a stop to that. Those mercs are seriously jeopardizing the Citadel's ability to defend itself if the war comes here. When the war comes here.
There are other ways to secure weapons, General.
You don't think I've tried? There's a black market dealer on Citadel right now, but he won't sell his top-line arms. The Reapers are destroying everything in their path, and I can't stop them. But I can stop the Blue Suns.
Let me see what I can do for you.
I'd appreciate your help, and I'll have a plan of action ready if things fall through.
We've got to keep Jake in daycare.
Welcome to the Citadel gift shop.
Azari Intelligence is reporting sightings of Reaper forces in the Selene Nebula.
Look, Commander, I don't want any trouble. I'm authorized to sell here, and all my arms are legal, see?
These are lightweight weapons. Where's your top-end inventory?
Shit, you slumming for C-Sec 2? I already got harassed by the old Turian with the bad attitude. Yeah, I got much better stuff, but it's off the market. Galaxy's going belly up. Credit won't mean anything once the Reapers rip through.
So what exactly are you saying?
Whatever happens, I figure there'll be survivors, but it'll be chaos. I'm betting things will run on a barter system. So I'm getting a jump. My best stock only trades for hard goods and artifacts with real value.
So what gets me access to your top shelf?
Heh, Turian just waved credits in my face and then spat on it. Nice to see you have flexibility. If you find any rare pieces when you're out saving the galaxy, bring them back. Then I'm happy to share my top stock with C-Sec, no problem. Outside of that, I gotta stick to my guns. Credits don't talk with me, Commander. C-Sec wants my top of the line. You gotta come through with a couple of artifacts.
Unless you can find a new source of weapons for C-Sec, I'm putting together a task force to stop the Blue Suns myself.
Excuse me, General.
Good to see you again, Shepard.
The General won't listen to reason. Take him out.
Well, it was worth a try.
One moment, please. Now arriving at the Perfidium Embassy.
Shepard, what do I owe the pleasure?
Here to talk to you about releasing Jonas Sedaris.
Damn, you too? Somebody got the Council to order her release. I'm delaying as best I can. What's your stake in this?
It's classified.
That's a fancy way of saying mind your own business. Look, there's no way I'm letting that psychopath out. The woman's unstable and a clear public threat.
I'd like access to her to judge for myself.
Sure thing. I'm sure you'll agree. Then maybe the Council will listen to you and rescind the order. Go to the C-Sec outpost. My assistant will connect to Sedaris' cell from there. Then call me back.
Connected with Jonas Sedaris in her cell, Commander. You can speak with her via that console.
Thanks. We'll need some privacy.
Of course. When you're done, you can also contact Commander Bailey from that terminal.
Who's that spying on me now? Ah, I see. Good. Arya's indentured servant has finally come to deliver me to freedom.
I want to talk with you before I secure your release.
Bullshit. You have no choice. And when I get out, heads will roll. Oh, yes. You've killed a lot of my people. Don't think I've forgotten that.
It'd be smart to bury the threats, Sedaris.
I'll toss them into the caskets with my victims. I love holding all the cards. Even in here, you must deal with me. I have all the power.
Is that right?
Yes. Sane, my second-in-command, is a weak-willed toady. If he had balls, he'd leave me to rot and take control himself. But he won't defy me. He knows better. Now get me out of here, Shepard. Tell Bailey to release me.
Bailey, I've seen Sedaris.
So she's crazy, right? It would be ridiculous to let her out.
She's a menace. Let me try to make this problem go away.
Sounds good. I'll hold the line until I hear from you.
You don't think Sanctuary is real?
One moment, please. Now arriving at Docking Bay E-24, emergency civilian housing.
Men, get ready for trouble.
Not here for that, Sane. Just want to talk about Jonas Sedaris' release.
Oh, you're the one coordinating that, right? My idea, you know. Arya came to me looking to gain Eclipse support. I'm leveraging it to bust the boss out.
Sane, you should run Eclipse.
Huh?
You can do it. Leave Sedaris locked up and make the deal with Arya yourself.
Arya would be a step up. And you think she'd let me run things?
I don't see why not.
Right. Then that's the plan. Keep Sedaris in jail. I'll call Arya right away.
Good man.
Shepard, the Council withdrew the release order for Sedaris. Arya T'Loak, of all people, got him to do it. Crazy.
You can say that again.
Thanks for your help, Shepard.
Welcome, Commander Shepard. Please select a destination. One moment, please. Now arriving at ward level purgatory.
I hate being stuck here. I hate this guard doing his assignment. I hate everything right now.
Didn't think I was making it off, Ben.
Do you guys have a tap?
Look who's here. The Blue Suns, Blood Pack, and Eclipse are in my pocket. I'll send them to war when you're ready for them. Is there anything on your mind? We'll talk later. I'm sure.
want you to match this against all known locations and update the map. Then contact the field teams for a progress report.
Yes, sir.
I'm Commander Shepard. We've been expecting you. Just a moment. And Hadley, could you gather the Leviathan data for us? Apologies, Commander. The rest of my team is out investigating leads right now. I'm Dr. Garrett Bryson, and this is Task Force Aurora.
What's your assignment?
Our mandate is to investigate legends, rumors, old stories about the Reapers before anyone knew they existed.
I could have used your help 3 years ago.
Yes. If people had paid attention to your warnings about the Reapers, we might not be in this war. But now with new information we've uncovered, a breakthrough's near. Hadley, do you have the data?
No!
This is Commander Shepard. I need C-Sec at my location, now!
You shouldn't be here. The darkness can't be breached.
Transit records show his name is Derek Hadley. He's worked here for a couple months.
Shepard, I monitored a C-Sec alert from this location. Were you harmed?
I'm fine, but I could use your help sorting this out, Edie. Take a look through their files. I need to know what this task force was up to.
At once.
What? What's happening?
You tell me.
I was gathering our data when you arrived, and then it was dark. Cold. Like I was someplace else.
And then?
I don't know! A gun was in my hand. Dr. Bryson, there was a loud noise.
You shot Bryson. You killed him.
No, I couldn't have. I'm not a murderer. I didn't do it. It wasn't me. You have to believe that.
So someone else pulled that trigger.
But I would never do that!
Commander, this does resemble reports of indoctrination.
Indoctrination? Me?
What about that Leviathan Bryson mentioned? How does that tie in?
It's some kind of creature. Our field teams have been tracking it. That artifact came in from our researcher, Garneau. He sent an audio log if you wanna...
What's wrong?
Turn back.
What are you talking about?
The darkness cannot be breached.
Get him over to the clinic. See if they can tell us what's wrong with him.
Yes, ma'am.
Commander, you'll want to see this. It's an outgoing message from Dr. Bryson to Admiral Hackett.
Dr. Bryson, you have an update?
Admiral, the Leviathan of Dis that we've been investigating, I think we're really onto something.
Give me the brief.
About 20 years ago, the Batarians discovered a Reaper corpse that had died in battle. They covered it up and denied it ever existed. But I'm intrigued by the larger implication.
What could have killed the Reaper in the first place?
Exactly. That's the real Leviathan.
It's worth pursuing. Continue your investigation and update me on the progress.
There is also a follow-up message from a few weeks later.
Admiral, the Reapers are shadowing my field teams as if they're hunting Leviathan themselves. Whatever it is, I believe Leviathan is nothing less than a Reaper killer. Almost an apex predator, and it has them nervous. If we could just find it, imagine the impact on the war. I'm formally requesting assistance in tracking it down.
You'll have it. This is now your top priority, Doctor. Find that thing.
It appears we were meant to be that assistance.
Anything capable of killing a Reaper could do a lot of collateral damage.
Yet given the state of this conflict, I believe the saying, "The enemy of my enemy is my friend," may be relevant.
But we won't know unless we can find it.
Bryson's assistant did say they recently received a log from their field researcher. It may yield more information.
This must be the artifact the assistant mentioned. And here's the log.
Dr. Bryson, it's Garneau. I'm sending you an artifact I found. About the only thing I found there, in fact. Maybe it's nothing, but I'd swear Leviathan came through here. I'm gonna crunch some numbers. Burn up the rest of this project travel allowance. Maybe I can project our Reaper killer's movements. I'll check in when I get to the next site.
Garneau appears to be our best lead to track Leviathan, but he does not state a destination.
Let's focus on what he does say, then.
He mentioned extrapolating Leviathan's path.
And crunching numbers. He wasn't flying blind. He had data.
A significant amount of data, judging by this office.
So how do we narrow it down?
Bryson and his colleagues evidently used a galaxy map search program in their hunt for Leviathan. It may help us locate Garneau.
Does this tell us where Garneau went?
No. But we may be able to narrow down his location if we find clues he was using in his search for Leviathan.
Sovereign. Hope they've got that thing shielded.
This appears to be encrypted data on Reaper fleet activity. Do you think it's relevant?
Sir, this is Bryson. We know the Reapers are after Leviathan. Studying Reaper hunting patterns could be vital to finding it.
That data is classified top secret, Dr. Bryson. If it falls into the wrong hands...
It won't. The data's encrypted. I'll keep the decryption key safe. Close to my heart.
Close to his heart? What the hell does that mean? Bryson was tracking unexplained creature sightings.
Bryson was not merely tracking sightings. He was attempting to extrapolate a course.
And Garneau could have been following that course. Edie, can you add a search filter for systems along that projected path?
Adding the search filter, you may examine the results on the Galaxy Map program.
By Anne Bryson, age 9.
Records indicate Anne is now 28. She works for the Alliance.
Bryson was keeping the encryption key close to his heart. What's closer than family? Looks like data on the Rachni.
March 7th, 2186. I'm looking at the Rachni. Their movements during the Rachni Wars suggest alien influence. But the timing is wrong, and Rachni weren't implanted with Reaper tech. What if Leviathan was preparing the Rachni to fight the Reapers?
What do you think, Edie?
It is possible that Bryson's team is using ancient Rachni fleet activity to find Leviathan. We saw a data pad containing data on Rachni movements earlier. It may be relevant.
Meteorite fragment, maybe?
He was studying it as an object of importance. We should look.
Meteorite sample with traces of element zero. Would Leviathan need Izo?
While it is not consumed as fuel during FTL travel, Element Zero will decay after several centuries of active use. If Leviathan is old enough, it would need to replenish its supplies.
Okay. Can you give me a search filter for locations with Element Zero?
Adding this search filter to the galaxy map.
Loch Ness Monster?
Plesiosaur.
Loch Ness Monster's more interesting.
Interesting and non-existent.
Thank you.
Another piece of Anne Bryson's childhood art. Wait a minute. Well, take a look at that. I can use these numbers to construct a decryption key. All right, let's get back to the data pad we found earlier.
Dr. Bryson, per your request, I'm clearing Task Force Aurora for intercepted Batarian communications regarding the Leviathan of Dis.
Commander, the Dreadnought is in custody, but the Solarians may have surveillance footage. Our ambassador will issue a full denial. Give me your preliminary analysis. Several million years old, at least. And its technology outstrips anything on the Council. Excellent. Our scientists will work day and night to bring its secrets to the Hegemony. One concern, Commander. The real Leviathan of Dis, the thing that destroyed the ship, is still out there. Unaccounted for. Irrelevant. The ship is our priority. And as far as the rest of the galaxy is concerned, there is no Leviathan of Dis. There never was.
These are all murders in which the accused lacked a known motive and claimed memory loss.
Just like Bryson's assistant. You think Garneau was following a trail of blackout crimes?
It is possible. We need to find data matching dates and...
Here's the time and date chart for the crimes. Can you filter for murders where the killer claimed memory loss?
Adding the search filter now.
Alien sightings.
Based on the search results, Garneau is in one of these five systems. I have marked the Normandy map with possible locations. We can leave now, unless you wish to further narrow the search.
Element zero deposits.
Three possibilities.
Blackout crimes.
No results. Some of our search parameters may be irrelevant. The Rachni data.
Can you add a cross-reference for locations of sightings?
Adding it now. Three possibilities.
Rachni activity.
No results. Some of our search parameters may be irrelevant. Three possibilities. Five possible systems.
Blackout crimes.
No results. Some of our search parameters may be irrelevant.
Rachni activity.
No results. Some of our search parameters may be irrelevant.
Element zero deposits.
No results. Some of our search parameters may be irrelevant. Three possibilities.
Commander, you've got a new message at your private terminal.
Admiral Stephen Hackett is a decorator. Miranda Lawson is a high-ranking former server. Thank you.